together.
Yeah, Digital Chaos, Dedication and Love, two really solid teams. Both have been actually doing really well in this qualifier.
Yeah, and I think the big surprise here is FTL coming on top of their group. Well, almost
top of their group. I believe Digital Chaos is actually on top.
Yes, they are being played. This is the last series that they'll play. FTL did split one series.
Okay, so if they do 2-0 this, then they actually will be tied.
Yes.
Wow.
If all Digital Chaos has to do is win one game.
Okay. Wow. Well, that's... Wow. Okay.
And in all seriousness, I am here with my good friend Conrad Jansen.
And I'm here with the lovely Charlie C. Yang. Welcome to Bad Kappa Studios, our equivalent for the other show casters, probably streaming on some other not as good site right now. No, I'm just kidding.
I ain't touching that.
No, I'm kidding. Yeah, I'm actually really excited for this game. Both these teams looking really, really solid. And more specifically, Digital Chaos. I think a lot of people were doubting them coming into this, but mm-hmm. looks like they proved themselves here.
Not only are they winning their games in a pretty dominant fashion, they're also doing it in a very versatile fashion. They're not picking the same lineup over and over. They're doing it in different ways. Picking Meepo, picking multiple carries, Drow strats, Furion. They're all over the place, and they're still winning. And that's really good to see out of them.
Yeah, I think that versatility is something you really want
to
see.
And you know what you need to pull off that versatility? Confidence. And that's something that the past Digital Chaos squads have not had.
Yeah, you know, I'm wondering if the leadership of Misery or, you know, some of the other... do you actually know who's coaching the team at the moment?
So they have brought in PyCat. This
okay.
is just recently... only at the start of qualifiers to help out with their team, work on internal issues with some of the players. And, you know, I think PyCat has... He brings a really good level head and a lot of experience to the front. And not only has he proven himself to be a great caster, but I think he's done a lot of great work with his DC squad.
Yeah, I mean, he's somebody I know that I think really fits well into that coaching role, with literally more experience than almost everybody in the scene.
Yeah.
He's been playing for so long, and I think he's familiar with a couple of these players as well. So
played with Misery for a very long
exactly.
time.
Exactly, and that relationship, I think, actually really helps, because there's that self-mutual, you know, respect for each other. And,
absolutely.
Yeah.
You know what I love about PyCat, especially in a coaching role? He's a ball buster. He doesn't take shit from almost anybody. If you're doing something wrong, he's not afraid to say it.
Yeah,
and I think that might have been detrimental to him when he was a player, but as a coach, in a lot of ways, that's great. That's what you have to really earn that respect.
No, I mean, yeah, for sure. It's when you see players like... Yeah, just, oh, yeah, everything's great. You know, we lost the game. That's cool, guys. No, you need to be told you did bad, even if you won the game sometimes.
Yeah.
And I think he's doing...
Well, yeah, and
really
you need
there.
To know why
yes.
you did bad
yeah,
as well.
Yeah, exactly. And he brings both those things to the table.
Mm-hmm. And jumping right into the draft, nothing too surprising so far. We've seen Doom, a very valued pickup all across every region so far. Slardar as well. Mirana, Batrider. Pretty typical so far.
Has Digital Chaos been playing the Mirana in the mid lane?
Resolution has played it mid. He's also played it safe lane. Like I said, they've given every team a lot of different looks across the board.
I think the one thing I really like the Mirana pickup now is that it's created a little bit of versatility in the drafts, where you pick something that could, you know, arguably go support, and you can completely change the tempo.
Right, it can
of the
go
draft
in
right
so many different lanes. You can play it mid, you can play it in that four position, you can also play it safe lane. I've even seen one team throw it in the off lane. Yes,
oh, really?
Funix played it
at
in the off
tournament.
Lane.
Wow,
yeah, Funix played it in the off lane. So. It's very open, very versatile, just like the Slardar, just like the Doom, and just like the Batrider.
Yeah, I think that's one thing that we're seeing a lot of teams right now focusing on, is that versatility at the beginning. You know, where can things go? That Doom can be in the jungle, it can be in the offlane. You're trying to force every team to think about what's going on. And we see the Meepo ban.
The respect ban. That, when you know a team is capable of picking it, executing with it, that's very scary, because there are so few players that are good with that hero, and there are even fewer teams that are comfortable running it.
Well, what's even more worrisome for a team like that is that how many people are thinking, oh, let me just think of this Meepo counter, and then you just pigeonhole yourself into this thought process that that might happen, and then they like just counter you anyway, so.
Yeah, I mean, it's Meepo is very similar to Alchemist in that it's in your mind, it's pressure. You're thinking, oh man, I have to deal with this hero. He's going to go out of control. He's going to be everywhere on the map.
Yeah.
And he's going to push all my lanes.
Oh, for sure. And the other respect, Ben, the Invoker for Resolution, that is a dangerous hero. That man plays that like nobody else.
Absolutely. On paper, this DC squad is probably one of the most individually talented teams in the American qualifiers.
Yeah, for sure. And do you know, I guess they were banning that Alchemist. Have we seen Resolution been playing that as well?
No, it's Wii plays the Alchemist.
Ah, okay. Interesting.
And what I do also like about both these teams, what they're doing, is in these qualifiers, what we've seen is that the teams that have multiple ways of initiating and starting a fight, not just relying on one hero, are the teams that usually come out and win those team fights. And now you have that with the Puck and the Batrider out of FDL. You have that out of the Slardar, Digital Chaos, and the Mirana somewhat. You can initiate with Arrow. You can initiate with Moonlight Shadow. These are very dynamic, very, you know, sort of do shit lineups.
Love that term. And it looks like this Doom has kind of pigeonholed itself into the four position here. I don't see it being in the offlane with both Puck and Batrider. And I think I don't know. I've seen mixed success with a lot of these jungle lineups in the past few games. Some teams have been executing it really well, and that Doom comes out, and you're like, "What's going on? I'm dying."
Ultimately, I feel like it depends on how much that jungle hero gets punished. And what you've been seeing out of almost every single game this qualifier is that Bounty Hunter is almost always a first two ban.
Mm-hmm.
And you're seeing that here. You do not want your greedy jungler getting disrupted.
Now, do you think they pick the Enchantress as sort of a flex pick to sort of counter that Doom a little bit, if possible?
Yeah.
And then, you know, worst case, you can throw it into the off lane with Mu playing that as well, as an option, I guess.
I agree. It is a support hero that also gets farmed, that also scales late game, and that can also move around the map and contribute to other lanes. You get a couple good creeps, you know, you net a Batrider or something. You can contribute with the Enchantress while also scaling late.
No, for sure. And they're picking up just a really solid laner here with Bane, you know.
You have, again, the classic Bane-Mirana combo. Works
disgusting.
Really well,
disgusting.
Unless your beat is.
Oh, damn! Shoutouts to Robert, long time friend of both of ours. Known for not hitting his arrows.
Only on slept targets.
On slept targets, yes. Just looking. FDL.
It's also great at zoning out heroes. Bane is one of the strongest level 1, not just supports, strongest level 1 heroes in the game.
Now, let's talk a little bit about FDL, as we've been focusing on Digital Chaos a lot here. Do you know if these are specialties of any of these players, any of these heroes actually fitting into that realm?
These guys play a lot of different things. As a group, MJW, Franz, all of these guys tend to five-man stack together. It's really, really disgusting. They're all friends of AUI 2000, and they'll all go into five-man rank together and just like,
hey, let's play some games.
Yeah.
And then they ruin somebody's day.
Yes. So they play all sorts of stuff, like the wild, crazy stuff. Sometimes they get really bored in those games and play, you know, just off the
wall. I imagine
you've
been a couple of those faces against some of those, because I know you stack a little bit with your friends, but like, you're at that level, but they're... Like that's the stack you get queued into. That's the problem.
Yeah, that's the problem.
You get stacked into like literally almost a professional stack.
And it's super annoying. But all these guys have been around for a while. MJW, their offlane player, has, you know, once like years ago was considered almost like one of those rising stars.
Yeah.
People thought that he was going to be really, really good.
He falls a lot into that like MSS line, where except he never actually made it to those pro teams ever.
Right. He I think He never fully committed to the game.
He stood in for Liquid. Then that's what happens. You stand in for Liquid, you're actually a good player. And then
that's your breakout. Liquid is the gateway.
Liquid
to
is
the
game back in the day. Remember MSS, you know, playing carry, and then gets brought on to Evil Geniuses during that time.
Mm-hmm.
MJW, I believe, the same thing. And then
he never really committed.
And that's the thing, yeah. He was always known as, like, I mean, that was the stand-in team back in the day, right?
Well, to give a little more background on FDL, since these guys are more unknown, we talked about MJW, Franz, also known as Frenzy / Elf Frenzy, Wilson Tsang, another good friend of AUI 2000s.
Yep.
He has played Dota since back in Dota 1.
Mm-hmm.
Long-time in-house member. Big memer.
Sounds like my jam.
Yeah. And then we have Bisa, the UK Hope.
Playing the carry, of course.
Yes. Protecting his sister. Everybody knows him.
Yeah.
And then CCNC, I think he's like 15 or 16.
Yeah, he's this up-and-coming superstar, right? Like,
well, we'll see if he's a superstar.
See. I mean, look at FDL's performances so far. I mean, that's NA, I guess. But, you know, like, he has been performing, and this is online, of course, as well.
Yeah, we'll see what happens when he gets to the big stage. We'll see what happens when he meets adversity. Really, the sign of a truly great player is not how hard you snowball, how meteoric your rise is, but how you deal with trouble, how you deal when you get knocked down, how you deal when your team isn't winning.
To be honest, I think this is going to be a really good case test for this. Digital Chaos, a very experienced team. Very like players that have been playing for a very long time, very good squad. I think I don't know if they've played before in anything else, but I
they played in the Frankfurt qualifiers. They didn't make it, but that was when all of their players were all around the world and they were playing on really bad ping, and they're
right.
Not exactly cohesive, and they did get knocked out by Shazam.
Got it.
Got knocked out by Colt.
Yeah. Damn.
Anyways, and the last member of FDL is Stan King.
He's just Stan King.
He's way too his friend.
Last
he's
two bands were
well.
Dragonite and Terrorblade, by the way, and the Morphling pickup.
Yeah, that's a Beast of staple.
See? It's also funny, because it reminds me of an MJW staple. Obviously, this is a long time ago.
Sure.
But that is also when Morphling was really good, too.
Yeah. A lot of people played that hero really well.
And the lone druid for the final pick. A little surprising, but...
Well, what do you think of these lineups?
You know, it really depends, I think, for me, on how Doom is going to do. If they shut down Doom with... I'm not sure if Mu's going to be playing it, but I don't think so. I think
Doom?
That's going to be... No, sorry. That's going to be a resolution. Sorry. Whoever's playing the Enchantress, if they're able to shut down the Doom...
Well, Mu is playing the...
I think
Slardar is a Mu hero.
So that's what I'm getting at, is Misery going to make his life bad? And we'll see. I mean, we'll find out in a few minutes.
Well,
here.
We have the Resolution Mirana mid, the Mu Slardar, and then... the Mu Slardar and the Misery Enchantress. Soxa on the Bane, we haven't talked about him too much, but he was a recent pickup. He was going to be on the original DC squad with AOI 2000 and Bulba, and ended up here. And those guys said that this guy has a lot of potential. Very good, very quick learner, and no ego.
Yep, and we got an immediate TP here from Stan King. Looks like he wants to drop a couple wards down here. Uncontested, hopefully. Looks like nobody TP'd, but Mu is immediately heading up top, but looks like they're going to be able to get
that's a six Slardar set.
Damn, that is... That's you know what that reminds me of? It's the Dragonite set. It's pretty badass. Damn.
I'm about it.
That does look pretty cool.
Anyways, so we have, not a lot... I would say the team fight on DC is a little weak?
Yeah,
they have some control with the Bane and the Slardar, maybe a Potomero. But I wouldn't say that the teamfight on FDL is that great themselves. Maybe a little bit better with the Puck and the Batrider Lasso.
No, for sure. I think what I think going to be the game plan for Weeha is just to get that Bear Beastly, which we've seen him do before many, many times, and just kind of carry the game a little bit later. I think if FDL is able to capitalize a little bit early on, they might be able to get some stuff done and maybe roll over DC if things go well. But I don't know. I just feel like Weehaw.
I don't think there's a huge drafting advantage. I actually do like FDLs a little more just because of that Doom pick against, you know, Slaughtar, Marana.
Mm.
And because of the fact that DC doesn't have the greatest control for Morphling either.
Yeah.
Yeah. Bane is okay, but you can still strength Morph through the Bane ult.
Yeah. And if you get that going, you're actually going to be hopefully making it out alive. Depends on if there's a big bear hitting you at the same time.
Yeah. Really, we'll see. Drafts, I would say, more or less kind of even.
Yeah.
It would just come down to lanes and execution here.
Yeah, Sasuke going for the courier. Does get it. Wow. I'm gonna say I'm surprised. At the same time, I'm not surprised. Immediately gets in there for that.
Yeah, that's pretty big for CNC and CCNC.
Yeah.
Lone Druid already does pretty well against Puck mid, and this is gonna make life even harder for him.
Yeah. Yeah, he's got the Stout Shield and the Quellian Blade. Spear Pair, just doing his damage, getting those creeps. Right now Doom in the jungle, as expected, and Misery also just in his jungle. Nobody really blocking any camps. So we'll see how that kind of goes down and see if that affects something later in the game.
You know, something that I think is a problem point for FDL right now is that Mu is basically in a 1v1 against Bisa.
Yeah.
And this might lead to a pretty fast Slaughtar Blink Dagger. Yeah, and something that you really want to shut down if you're FDL is that Blink Dagger speed, because a lot of initiation is going to come out from that.
No, for sure. And I think Stan King's doing a good job pulling here, though. So, Mu's able to actually steal the big creep there. So, yeah. I don't know. Hopefully Stan King, because I feel like Crystal Maiden is good in the lane, but it just depends if they keep pulling like this and Mu, and if he's able to abuse the lane, which he's been doing a very good job in the offlane with.
Yeah, and I wouldn't say that CM Morphling is that good at really shutting down a Slardar.
Definitely, it's definitely not a kill lane or anything like that. It's
Mu has to make some serious mistakes for him to die here.
Yeah.
So he's gonna get more than FDL is probably comfortable with. Yeah, Doom denies himself to the neutrals
on purpose.
I hope that's on purpose.
He did buy. That's the thing. I'm always worried when I see that, and I wasn't clicked there, and I wasn't sure. But he did buy up before he died, so he's got his tranquils now, and he's actually picked up a windlace. So he's a little speedy guy now.
And lanes are actually going pretty well for DC to begin with. Mu's getting farm in the off lane. He's not getting too zoned out. With that courier snipe, Wii is doing really well mid. And I gotta say, Misery's having a pretty good time in that jungle as well.
Yeah, he's really getting
top
a lot
of the leaderboards.
Yeah, and same thing actually with Resolution. He's really farming out that lane really well. Pretty much uncontested, it looks like, versus
Batrider. MJW is not having the easiest time here, as he is still only level 2 and he's got 4 creeps to Mu's 8.
Yeah, looks like going on top, Mu ends up taking out Crystal Maiden, but ends up getting taken back by Bisa playing the carry.
Still totally worth.
Yes.
Your offlaner gets first blood against 3 heroes.
Yeah, I know for sure. He's definitely making the plays right now. Only very, very, very little bit behind Bisa.
Who is
playing the carry? In terms of net worth, just after that first blood gold.
Yeah, so really good start for DC here. He's got his tranquils now. It's going to be really hard for FDL to zone him out. Almost, I'd say they're not going to have any chance of zoning him out. Franz is coming around behind, maybe to try and wrap around on Mu, but I would say this isn't high percentage. This can be pretty risky.
Yeah, we got a Bane going on MJW here. Looks like they're going to take him out. Misery got the double damage. This is going to be a lot of damage and barely gets taken out just before the Granite Golem takes him out to be a neutral kill.
And there was a failed gank attempt on Mu up top, as he did end up getting a really nice crush onto 2 heroes, and they didn't have the damage to finish him off.
Yeah.
Franz did not get that Infernal Blade off on Mu. And it looks like Wii is also going to pick off CCNC in the mid lane. That's unexpected.
And
this is
like,
just going...
And Boo actually gets on top as well, also able to take out the Crystal Maiden again.
This is going all sorts of bad for FDL right now.
Mm-hmm.
None of these lanes going as they anticipated, with that bottom tower also getting taken out by...
Oh, and they get the arrow on MJW here. They're jumping in. Looks like they're going to get all the damage they need, and down goes that MJW on the Batrider there.
Yeah, and this is pressure on the tier 2 now. This is not good at all for FDL.
Yeah. Bonds looks like he wants to do something in the back here, but I just don't think it's going to get... I'm actually worried about Stan King here. He's looking up a little forward. Oh, looks like we got a TP coming in from MJW.
Yeah, they have to do something.
And they're going to back off. And
well, Franz going in.
Yeah. Sasuke taking a lot of damage, gets the brain sap off, but looks like he's going to get taken out here. Just, you know, he's going to sacrifice himself for the good of the team. And the other two get away, both Resolution and Misery.
I think if they had more mana on Resolution, he might have tried something there.
Yeah,
as
sure.
The rest of them are low level, a crush onto Bisa.
Play the carry. Can't believe you pointed at me for that.
You said you do it every single time.
I think I out-memed myself on this one. But yeah, it looks like Mu actually looks like he's going to be picking up some interesting items. They're on the courier now. That infused raindrop and another enchanted mango. But looks like the hand of Midas for Misery here already. He is making bank and
he rushed that.
Yeah. Oh, Bisa taking a lot of damage here, but he is able to make it out. Mu already level 6 with that amplified damage, and you know, able to take a big chunk out of Bisa's health.
Yeah, he's not having the easiest time here.
No, for sure. And MJW just resorting to a little bit of jungling there, just trying to get some farm and some levels.
Yeah, he doesn't really have a choice. He's behind already. His first rotations haven't really done too much. Oh,
uh-oh.
There's a sleep on Bisa, but
yeah,
with that
a lot
TP in from Stan King, they're going to back out.
And I think they saw something up, especially because they see Fawns in the jungle with that ward. But, oh, looks like they're staying a little bit, and here comes Fawns with the Hurl Boulder. Ends up getting a significant amount of damage on Mu, but it looks like he's not going to pursue
that ability
further.
Is so good. Not the Hurl Boulder.
Scorched Earth, right?
No.
Infernal Blade?
Infernal Blade.
Okay.
That is insane. Do you see
this...
how much damage Mu took off of one Infernal Blade?
Yeah, but it's also like...
It's a level 1 Infernal Blade.
But see, I think the Scorched Earth is like, yo, free radiance, bzz, and now I'm zapping your health. And I just think that ability in combination with Infernal Blade...
Yeah, dude, now... I mean, there's a reason he's... been first pick, I think, out of more so out of any other hero this tournament.
Damn, Statsman Charlie here. But we actually don't know that, by the way. But one thing that is...
It's a Chardeep stat,
yeah.
So...
Okay, gotcha. One thing to note about that, though, is that Infernal Blade at level 4 with 4... Oh, looks like you're going on to Bisa here. And they're going to get some damage. If he gets...
the double centaur?
Yep, going to get the stomp. He is trying to power through this with the Morph
Strike.
Oh,
no.
But...
Worst possible scenario, Stan King, who tried to be the hero to take that sleep off, is going to... go down as well, as he didn't get it off in time.
Looks like he was a little too late there, and it looks like they're maybe looking to push here with all three. And yeah, that was a really rough fight for the FDL boys.
So if you are the coach / manager of FDL, what would you tell them at this point?
I would say, don't listen to me. I don't know enough about this game. That's exactly what I told Cloud9. But yeah,
maybe you didn't have enough confidence in yourself. Maybe that's why they didn't make it, dude.
Got me. But I'll tell you this. The first thing I told the team when I managed them was, if I ever recommend anything, please just tell me to shut up. Because I know you're better than me. Oh, looks like they're going on Bisa, playing the carry here. He is morphing strength, trying to get through. Mu's doing a lot of damage. And Sasuke, looks like he's going to get caught out. I don't know if they're going to be able to. He nightmares himself. Bisa trying to go through, but gets a puck coil off on Misery here.
Oh, Sasuke will get away.
Yeah, and he actually makes it out. And Fawns looks like he's going to try and chase here.
They might get Misery here.
Yeah,
they should.
They did get the ensnare. This should go down no matter what. And, yeah.
But it was a lot of rotations, all for an Enchantress that...
And
Midas
is
on cooldown.
Yeah, Midas is on cooldown.
You know what's also really interesting?
Mm-hmm.
Enchantress went for the Phase Boots.
That's interesting. I wonder if they're just really trying to chase him down and just get in their grills and start doing damage. I think, like, Misery, he feels so ahead right now. He might already be opting for that DPS type build.
Oh, he's definitely going for it. Well, he got a Midas.
Yeah, I know. I mean, even faster than like. I do you not like the face boots? I think it's actually a good.
No,
chase.
No. I think I think it's fine. Yeah. Especially because they're so ahead. He can bully so many heroes with that.
Yeah, they just can't get away. Like, look how fast Enchantress is right now. It's just it already got 380 move speed. Like with, and that's not with face boots up. And then on top of that, maybe you drop like a windlace in there. You're
yeah, they're super far ahead right now.
Yeah.
Weehaw also took that mid tower. All their lanes are getting pressured.
Yeah, Sasuke does see Fawn's there doing that jungle camp, but looks like they're not going to be able to catch him as he just leaves before Resolution's able to get in.
This is really on. So, interesting enough, MJW also opts to skip the Blink Dagger and goes for drums first.
Oh, interesting.
Personally, not a big fan. I've seen other people do this before.
There was a talk about it, and I don't know if you read that thread where
yeah.
it explains the reasoning. Sometimes you just want pie, dude, or I don't know what he said. It was and ice cream
sometimes
and
you just want pie, so you eat pie. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, top tier analysis, Winter.
Oh. And it looks like they're going to get the Doom off here on Misery. Stan King trying to chase. He wasn't able to get that Crystal Nova off. Looking to try and get that Frostbite, but Franz doing a lot of damage to that Scorched Earth.
Are we going
to
get a Nanai? Is going to live? Well, he's not going
to. I think he's going to live. We do actually have a fight in the back here. Boo caught out. Looks like he's going to get. He's going to go down. Oh, wow. Oh, my. I can't believe he actually escaped that.
Oh, that uphill miss.
And looks like Franz is going to go down here. And Weehaw getting pulled to the high ground, but Misery does eventually go down to Bisa playing the carry, and Weehaw actually goes down as well. So that was a 2-for-1 trade.
That was a 2-for-2.
Sorry, that's right. He did respawn.
But in the end, you know, that's actually still pretty good for FDL. They're Wee goes down, and the Enchantress goes down.
Yeah, and looks like Puck went for the Veil of Discord before the blink. And
we've seen that. That's pretty common. You want the extra burst.
Yeah, and I think we're seeing that more just because, you know, this team is a kind of magic heavy team. You can get a lot of extra damage on if you just drop that Veil in a big team fight.
Yeah. In the end, that trade ultimately in FDL's, I would say still in FDL's favor, just because if you're that far behind, any even trade is good.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, they're 7.5k behind net worth right now. And, you know, just looking at the graph here, I think that's pretty rough, and in terms of XP, they're just under 4k, so they're looking at ways to try and catch up, and you'll take a 2-for-2 trade at any time for that.
Yeah, especially when you get that lone druid.
Yeah. Now, it's like DC smoked here. Don't know what they want. Looks like it's going to be Roche, maybe? Nope. They're backing off. Looks like they want to head mid. FDL kind of posturing at their tier 2. I think they think something is up.
Well, I think they've seen that Batrider has used Firefly,
and looks like he's going to go down. That Resolution Arrow perfectly launched right with Mu there, and they take him out. And looks like actually FDL smoked, and then Bisa ends up attacking that Cramp. So the smoke is gone, but the other two are going to keep going. That's Stan King and Franz. They do see everybody mid, though, taking out their tier 2, and this 5-manning is taking a lot of damage. MGW trying to cut the creep wave on bot lane to try and push out that bot, but they're going to get that tier 2, I think, unless they come back and start and save it.
Well, Mu gets doomed, but he's just going to run away. I think Franz was a little scared there. It felt like he had to do it.
Yeah,
that smoke was just to get that deep ward into
and
the raiding jungle.
Oh, barely dodges Franz, but they do see Stan King and he's going down. There's no way he's getting out of that one.
Well,
they still do see Franz, but it looks like he's going to make it out. Curious if MJW is going to get caught here. He's playing with fire with seeing a lot of those team members there, but looks
he
like
should just get out.
Yeah, and it looks like they're just going to go into the jungle. He does have a TP in case. And he will be able
to. He is so close to that blink dagger. Just get out, dude.
Yeah.
Just get out. You need that dagger.
Seriously. Oh, no. He's greedy. He wants that wave.
Oh, man. MJW, what a player. Let's
see what he does. They do see Sasuke there, and they do end up getting him here in the mid lane. They're trying to blow him up, but Mu with a great Slithering Crush. And it looks like, you know, Pop still unfortunately does go down, but it looks like they might get 2-for-1 here with Bisa Drush getting attacked.
No, they won't get Bisa.
Yeah, but oh, maybe they might get Stan King. And Stan King ends up going down there after just trying to come in and save. That's unfortunate. And it looks like they know where that Observer Ward is now, so they're going to try and get that out as well.
Yeah. Great play by DC. I understand why FDL went on that. You know, you're this far behind. You have to do something. You can't just sit there in your base.
Yeah, exactly. And without taking those risky plays, you know, a lot of the teams get faltered for, why would you do that? It's like, when you're this far behind, you really need to start doing stuff.
And MJW almost has his dagger. This will really be a catalyst for FDL to make something happen.
Yeah, I think, you know, he's going to be able to set up that initiation that they really need right now.
Oh, man, he got none of those last hits.
I saw.
That's so sad.
It's okay.
He's got it now, though.
Yeah, he did get the dagger. He's all good to go. He's getting ready. Sasuke just kind of wandering around in the enemy jungle. I don't know if he's posturing, but he does have a bunch of wards, and he does want to lay them down, but they do see Bisa, actually, and I think this wraparound from Sasuke is actually going to end up taking him out. Unless he can get that arrow by resolution.
Though,
and into the grip. It looks like he's going to go down no matter what. The carry. Gone.
He's going to have to wait about 40 seconds to play the carry once again.
And resolution, already getting that eggs. Wow, that 50-minute eggs timing. Not too shabby.
Oh, it's because the standard Midas Aquila into eggs, and his farm is just going to ramp up after this.
Yeah, same thing with Weehaw. Both their farm right now, I mean, he's only a few gold away, maybe about 200 gold away. This tower, if he does get it, will give him the Radiance on the bear, and actually his Midas will be off cooldown first, so he's gonna be getting this.
I gotta say, this is such a solid game coming out from DC. Not a lot of gimmicks, nothing too crazy, just solid rotations, really good Dota.
Yeah,
winning lanes, pressuring them, and taking map control.
There's been nothing really flashy that they've been doing. It's just, yeah, like you said, solid gameplay.
Yeah, and this is something I don't think we've really seen out of the past DCs.
I can agree with that. He did try to be a little bit flashy.
Yeah, I mean, when you have Bulba on your team and he theorycrafts a bunch of weird stuff, you're going to have some interesting drafts come out.
Yep. And they did get an arrow on CCNC, but it looks like they're not going to be able to get it.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Resolution. Oh. What are you doing? He's actually doing so much damage with that Axe, but the five-man smoke actually does end up being effective, as he tried to be a little cheeky there.
Yeah, that was... He felt himself a little too much.
Yeah, and that is worrisome sometimes when you... You know, we just talk about solid play. That is a maneuver you're not supposed to be making, you know?
No.
Regardless
he's
of how...
He's by himself, leaps into the trees.
Yeah, regardless of how ahead you are, like, you really shouldn't. So, looks like Weehaw's going to push this top tower, though, here, and I don't think they're going to be able to rotate in time to take it out.
No, this will be a free tower. Wee does have his Radiance now.
So, if you were in the position of FDL's coach, what would you be telling them right now to get them back into this game?
They really have to use their smoke successfully and try and get a pick off using the Batrider. And just, you know, one step at a time, try and get a pick off, try and claw your way back into this game, make high percentage plays.
Yeah.
And don't go for anything too crazy. You guys have to stay together or else you're going to get picked off by Bane, Mirana, and the Slardar. So just stick as four or five, let the Morphling split push around the map, and then the other four golfs with Batrider. Yep.
And looks like DC is going for the Roshan here. Look, they're probably going to end up taking it out and probably looking to push high ground. I don't see FDL contesting this, just with Stan King so far away to scroll. I don't think they're even aware this is happening at the moment. So, yeah. They did see the scan. But here they come. But I think they might just be... Oh, wow. Actually, DC backing off. Very, very good.
Yeah, the bear is kind of low, and you are fighting into a Batrider.
Yeah, I mean, I appreciate the patience from them. I think that's a...
There's no need to take the risk.
Exactly.
And, again, so many of these fights throughout this entire tournament dictated by vision and initiation.
Of course.
If you don't see the other enemy because you're in the Roshan pit, don't take that fight.
100%. Now has a Lichen Sphere, so he's going to feel a little bit more protected, hopefully, with his Replicate.
Did that ward see that smoke? They might have caught the outside of it. It is daytime, so that ward might have seen that smoke.
I don't see them backing up. Oh, they're actually
going in.
They see each other, and team fight happening. CNCNC only gets the coil on Mu. MJW pulling Misery back into that ultimate from the CM, but it looks like it's nothing going to happen. Morphling does get a kill on Slardar, but he is tanking a lot of damage right now, and I don't think he's going to be able to make it out of here. Unless
the Enchantress does die. They're running out of damage.
Wow.
I think Beast is going to get out of here.
Yeah,
as this fight gets turned around, Resolution might go down. Oh! Wow.
And Misery.
Wow. CCNC. What a player with that dodge.
And Misery actually buying back here. Looks like he's going to get CCNC. Oh, unfortunately not able to get the Blink Dagger off, and what a team fight, actually.
What a great team fight coming out of FDL. They fought into the Potom ultimate,
mm-hmm.
Only got a coil on one hero, but still managed to trade, not only trade evenly, but get the buyback out of misery as well.
I mean,
kill the Marana and the Slardar.
Yeah, and that actually, you see a little bit of the chunk coming out of DC's network. They're still up by 10,000 gold at this moment, so. Oh, and sorry, looks like Morphling unfortunately going down.
Went for the solo kill on the Bane, but still ends up dying.
This might not be worth.
Not worth.
I honestly, like, everybody knew Roshan was up, so getting that, you know, you want to be able to get that. And Vlad's picked up by Weehaw, and MJW actually getting the Boots of Travel, so. Franz taking a lot of damage right now, and he's going to go down instantaneously. And actually, they're going to go on MJW here. Resolution really going in. And they're just following. They're going to try and get CCNC and MJW, but Stan King does go down in that fight as well.
Great. That's great presence of mind from CC. Despite that bad fight, they still knew they were ahead, knew where they were in terms of ability to take fights, and still turn around.
CCNC going in for a little blink action there, trying to be a little tricky, trying to clear that wave as best as possible. But I do agree, DC right now playing like a tier one team with, you know, that mindset. You know, you lost a huge fight there, and you obviously some teams actually, you know, they get really overconfident, they feel really, but they actually took that other fight, the next following fights, no problem because they were thinking ahead and they were ready for
it. I will say that was a big mistake out of Bisa though.
I think that soul kill was a huge mistake, but it was also MJW and the rest of them getting caught. The wary in their mind to be
it's
able to.
It's the chain feed.
Yeah, it was really the chain feed. And like, you know, when you're coming in one at a time like that, you're just gonna get caught. Like, this team is fast and they're gonna catch you. You know, Resolution just able to get in there. Now he's got Boots of Travel, so he's moving at 400 movement speed. Like, these guys are not slow.
Yeah, and he's been hitting his arrows too.
Yeah, and something we didn't mention is Sasuke having the Glimmer Cape is going to be able to provide additional defensive support for a lot of the teams. And Bisa looks like he's going to be going the.
He's going the shotgun build.
Yeah, he wants to blow people up, so he's going to be aiming for, you know, a lot of those less tanky targets. So the Bane.
The thing is that what less tanky targets are there now?
I mean, I think
Bane has a Glimmer Cape. He's got 1,000 HP himself.
Yeah.
Maybe you want to go for the Enchantress.
I think you focus on the Enchantress.
That Enchantress is still pretty big herself.
Yeah,
she's
I mean,
got the Dragonlance, drums. She's gonna have an Agnum. Probably what is she, nothing on the courier so far,
no.
But they gave her
MJW being chased up by Mu is so close and actually almost able to get him. But no, I agree. I think the Enchantress is the only kind of target. They're worried, I think, for later game. And Blink Dagger coming out for Resolution here. Very excited. Now even more maneuverable to destroy.
Yeah,
he
wants to be able to use that leap as an escape ability.
Yeah,
he wants to use Dagger as a way to really get into fights.
Yeah, and I think, you know, we're talking about them playing really solid Dota, but I could also see them playing some very fancy Dota coming up soon here in the next coming fights.
Yeah, this is a team that's starting to feel really confident about themselves.
Yeah, and MJW just gets caught here, TP'd bottom, Mystery gets him, dominating now. The Dragonlance and the Hand of Midas and the Phase Boots, and he's just doing a lot of damage with that Impetus.
I think he did not expect them there. FDL, you saw they did use a scan in their own jungle. They thought DC was all up in there, but nope.
Yeah.
Ganking the Batrider.
Yeah, so it looks like they're getting some of these defensive wards out, but like, look at DC's warding here at the top lane and the mid lane.
Oh, very aggressive.
Yeah, super aggressive, really solid, and looks like DC's actually going to be pushing this bot lane. Misery feeling really strong. He's got that Aegis. He's got his Nature Attendant.
Yeah,
so.
Batrider's down. So... no lasso initiation.
Yep. Yeah, it looks like they're feeling a little bit safer. Bisa ending up having to TP back here. They look like they want to take a fight. Everybody's up, so we'll see what we see here in a couple seconds.
Yeah, and Morphling still doesn't have that shotgun.
Wow. I mean, Bisa's been trying his best to get back into this game, but just looking at Resolution and Weehaw, like their net worth, they've been farming really well this game.
Two Midases will do that for you. Three
yeah.
Midases,
yeah,
actually,
yeah.
With Misery.
This is the Misery special, right? Everybody Midas?
is that the Misery?
Remember when LGDN, when he was playing support, he invented the Crystal Maiden Midas?
That's true.
That is some disgusting times.
Oh, how far we've come with Dota.
Oh, yeah.
We've gone from endless stacking in the jungle to Midas on every hero to... you know, command center scans for both teams.
Thank you, StarCraft 2, for that one.
Hey, we got Tome of Knowledges, too.
Yeah, dude. Knowledge.
Oh, hey.
But you know what I talked about is the ultimate swag late game is if you go into, like, a 90-minute game, you drop, like, 4 Tomes of Knowledge. Oh, and cool. Fawn's getting caught out, and he gets blown up. Sasuke just giving him that brain sap, getting that extra damage so Misery can finish him off with the Impetus.
Ooh, that arrow just barely misses his tank.
I still think he wants to go in on this. He thinks he looked like he almost had the damage, and good attempt by the ultimate with Sand King there, but unable to actually capitalize on that.
Looks like DC wants to pressure mid with that Doom down.
Yep, and
I would still be pretty careful here. I believe they only have one bear.
Yeah, and actually they did lose the Aegis as well from Misery, so I'm curious if they're just going to take a step back and go back to farming here with the Resolution already heading into the bot lane.
I would say they should wait for the pipe on Solidar.
Yeah.
To counteract the Veil, there is a lot of magic damage and wave a decent amount of wave clear on FDL.
No, definitely agree with that. Oh, Puck trying to go for some tricky plays, but oh wow, actually able to dodge that Slithering Crush. He's going to end up trying to get out, but forcefully just gets caught out, unable to yield and trying to escape there at the end.
Yeah, that's a nice little boulder toss by the Enchanted Mud Golem.
Yep.
Very cute by Misery.
Yeah, and MJW actually being able to try and at least cut these lanes on top, so they're not going to be pushed in on multiple lanes at the same time. But it does look like DC is looking to do something here mid.
Yeah, Puck doesn't have buyback. They're going to test it out. If he doesn't buyback, they're gonna go in. Oh, doesn't look like they're going to go mid, opting for the exposed racks bottom instead.
Yeah.
Clearing out the wards, lone hitting that range racks.
Lots of damage. Oh, imagine that... that Frost actually ends up going on the Mud Golem instead. That'd be a sad day.
Yeah, that'd be a Conrad play.
Yeah, got me, dude. Yeah, and, both the bottom racks ended up being taken out by DC there. Almost no contesting from FDL.
This game looks pretty grim for FDL. Morphling finally has that Ethereal Blade now. Gonna see if he can pump some damage out, but really... When you get that F-Blade, you want to be able to blow up a hero almost immediately. You can't really do that to anybody anymore.
The only thing I can see actually happening is you use the Veil in conjunction with some Puck, you know, some of those Puck magic abilities, and then Bisa comes in there, blows him up,
mm-hmm.
maybe replicates out or something, you know.
At that point, after that, what do you do?
I mean, and on top of that, like...
You have no more damage anymore.
Yeah, exactly, and I think you're only blowing up, like... a Bane, or maybe I think the Marat. I don't even think so.
No, you're not blowing up the...
You're not blowing up anything. I hope like they get enough damage to do something like that, but I just don't see that. It's a little, you know, this is the build 20 minutes. Well,
if you synchronize all your spells, you could probably blow up the Enchantress, and that's your...
That would be your best bet, yeah. And DNC, kind of playing it tricky. Roche is about to spawn in a couple seconds here. They do end up using their scan. They were worried that they were in their secret shop area.
See nobody.
Yeah, unfortunately, I don't actually have seen DC use their scan quite a bit. Have you been noticing any of that?
No, it's been off cooldown for a while now. I don't think they really need to use it. They have a pretty good idea of where FDL is all the time, and that's trapped inside their base.
And speaking of which, they just checked that area as well, but... I'm actually kind of surprised
they have
a ward there, so maybe they were worried about a smoke coming in, but unfortunately nothing like that happening.
I think DC is going to wait for that Roshan respawn. It should come up in about, I can't read this clock because I'm not actually a caster, but not very long.
That sounds about right. I'll say they have 15 seconds.
All right.
And FDL did just get their smoke over deceit restocked here, and looks like they're gonna go on
just
top
a sleep
here.
On Bisa.
Yeah.
Playing the carry.
And Resolution coming in. They do get the Fiend's Grip off. Move with the amplified damage. I think they're gonna get him. Oh. And Fawn's able to get the Doom off on Sasuke, but he did get the pipe off. Or sorry, Mu did get the pipe off. So it looks like they have enough damage. They are chasing Fawn's and. They are going after the rest of them too, and Fawns goes down as well.
And as they say, as those two heroes go down, Roshan has respawned, but
yep.
It looks like DC even care?
No, I think they're fine, and DCNC able to get away there. Doesn't look like he's going to TP back. I don't think he can do anything to Misery here without some extra support.
MJW, don't get caught out here.
Yeah, Mu definitely looking to do some damage, but
they have a... If he didn't blink back there, pretty sure Mu was going to go in on that.
Yeah, and almost gets the arrow on him. That flame break damage, though, did save him. I think Mu would have immediately jumped in. and Resolution really going in there, just kind of creating space for the other guys to start demolishing that tower. But they are missing CCNC.
Well, they should just take this tower, and well, they're gonna go for the racks.
I just don't think there's anything they can do. Beast's down. They do know where
Glyph is down.
Oh, they do get the area on Frost, so he's not even gonna be able to come in here. And yeah, they do get the tower, but they actually know where everybody is, and they look like they're gonna be able to escape. Misery just ends up sniping the Crystal Maiden there,
wow.
And MJW the same thing. Wow. And you know what? Like, there's nothing that looks like. Oh, he almost does blow up Misery, but as
that
said,
Glimmer Cape,
it's just not enough. And comes in, they're going after Beast now. Looks like he's about to go down here.
And they'll call the GG.
Yeah, I think this is the GG, and there's nothing you can do. Yeah, GG, well played from FTL. DC putting on a clinic this game, really showing why they're
very
number
solid
one in their
game.
Really number one in their
no
bracket.
Gimmicks, just really solid draft overall, really solid lanes.
Yeah.
No huge misplays out of them.
Yeah, that's the thing. They're not doing anything flashy. They're just playing their game. And, you know, I wonder if that's a PyCat thing, or maybe, you know, that's the team coming together. And I think they're doing a